A very good evening, one and all present here. Honorable Director Sir of NIT Rourkela, Professor Animesh Biswas, esteemed guest of today's inaugural ceremony, Professor Ramaji Prasad, IEEE Fellow, Founder President of CTIF Global Capsule CGC, Professor of Future Technologies for Business Ecosystem Innovation in Department of Business Development and Technology, Aarhus University, Herning, Denmark. Professor Asutosh Datta, Fellow IEEE Communication Society Distinguished Lecturer, Founding Co-Chair for IEEE 5G Initiative, US, John Hopkins University, US. And Professor Itisah Mishra, Vice Chairman IEEE Kolkata Section, Jadavpur University. Professor Dipti Patra, HOD Electrical Engineering, and Professor Suman Kumar De and Professor Sambit Bakshi, co-coordinators of this course. Dear participants from academia and industries, faculty colleagues, research scholars, and students, it's a great opportunity to welcome you all for this inaugural session of this 5 days continuing education program on futuristic wireless communication and IoT, 5G and beyond. As the coordinator of this course, I feel privileged to offer my sincere thanks to all of you for giving your valuable time to attend this program. We are very much fortunate to have you all distinguished guests amongst us. Now let me brief a little bit about this course, presenting its overview. This 5 days course on futuristic wireless communication and IoT, 5G and beyond is designed to know about the technological challenges, opportunities, and adoption of 5G and beyond technologies globally. 5G is the next generation wireless communication and network that enables innovation and supports progressive change across all verticals of industry and society at large. The forecast for future 10 years wireless traffic demand illustrates an increase in 1,000 scales and more than 100 billion connections of Internet of Things. This poses a big challenge for future mobile communication technology beyond year 2020. With growing IoT needs, networking should be ubiquitous, energy and spectrum efficient, ensuring quality of service and adequate security. Further, the congregation of 5G and artificial intelligence is expected to accelerate the adoption of Industry 4.0. In these 5 days of course duration, a team of distinguished experts from academia and industries are invited to present their vision and share their expertise on various topics related to the near future of wireless communication and networks. So this course is well suited for engineers, faculties, and research scholars pursuing PhD, and also will be beneficial to gain an in-depth technical exposure to emerging 5G technologies, applications, and services. Also the potential research directions ahead. The undergraduate and the postgraduate students who would like to explore the latest research in future wireless technologies in their career can take the full advantage of this short-term course. The participant will also get an exposure to practical implementation of some of the upcoming wireless technologies through demonstrative lectures by industry experts. Now let me brief the topics to be covered. We are very much fortunate that today's keynote lecture on 5G and the modernization of industry from Industry 4.0 to smart cities will be delivered by Professor Ramaji Prasad, a distinguished expert and a pioneer in wireless technologies. Subsequent topics to be covered in this course are radio technologies for cellular IoT, making 5G new radio a commercial reality, design and analysis of massive MIMO systems under non-idealities, security in SDN, NFV, and 5G networks, opportunities and challenges, network slicing for 5G and beyond MAC layer, 5G challenges and enabling technologies, introduction to AI for 5G systems, cognitive radio and 5G communication, 5G prototyping, massive MIMO and millimeter wave systems, millimeter wave for smart sensing, UAV networks, architectures, opportunities, challenges, and future, reliable communication in ultra-wideband body area network. Also, developers' approach to multi-camera large-scale intelligent video analytics. Further, we should have will have Warshoot 6GB.
Madam, not audible. Not audible.
Okay.
Unmute.
Yeah. 5G system simulation using SystemView's 5G library. 5G system prototyping using LabVIEW and USRP. I would like to highlight about the distinguished speakers invited for delivering lectures in these 5 days. Professor Ashutosh Datta, I have already mentioned. Professor Prasanta Mahapatra, Vice Chancellor of Research, Distinguished Professor of Computer Science, University of California, Davis, US. Professor Mohammad Slim Aloini, Fellow IEEE Communication Society, Distinguished Lecturer, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Professor Sudeep Misra, Humboldt Fellow, INA Fellow, IIT Kharagpur. Professor Itisa Misra, I have already mentioned. Professor Chandra Murthy from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Professor Subrasekhar Das, IIT Kharagpur. Professor Pritam Kumar, IIT Patna. Professor Debarati Sen, IIT Kharagpur. Professor Devabrata Das, IIIT Bangalore. Speakers from industry are Dr. Kapil Bhattad, Principal Engineer at Qualcomm Bangalore, Dr. David Soldani, CTO Y Australia, Mr. Srinivasan Selva Ganapati, Senior Specialist Radio Standards Bell Labs and CTO Nokia Solutions, Mr. Tushar Brin, Director Samsung Semiconductor India Research, Dr. Pallav Maji, Senior Solution Architect Deep Learning, NVIDIA Graphics, Mr. Nilutpal Chaudhary, Technical Consultant, Embassies Technologies, India. I am glad to share that this course is sponsored by TechCube3 of our institute, and I record my sincere thanks to Professor Chittaranjan Patra, coordinator of TechCube3, for that. I am highly indebted to IEEE Future Networks 5G initiative and IEEE Comsec Kolkata chapter for technically co-sponsoring this event and giving it a wide coverage. I am also thankful to IEEE Region 10 coordinator Professor Rui Jiang to approve 2 numbers of virtual distinguished lectures for this course. I am very much grateful to our director, Sir Professor Biswas, for his constant encouragement, and HOD Electrical Engineering Professor Dipti Patra for her motivation and support for organizing this program. I express my appreciation to HOD Computer Center Professor BD Sahu and his team for providing necessary technical support. I am extremely thankful to Professor Ashutosh Datta and Professor Itisa Misra for their continuous support starting from the day of conception of this course. In addition to this, I also thank my co-coordinators for helping me to organize this event. Last but not the least, I must thank all the participants from India and abroad who have shown their interest in this program and enrolled in this program. Thank you all. Now, I request my co-coordinator, Professor Suman Kumar De, Electrical Engineering, to take over. Professor De.
Okay. Thank you, madam, for handing over the session to me. First of all, I want to introduce myself. That myself is already mentioned that I am Dr. Suman Kumar from Electrical Engineering. So good evening, all of you. It is an honor for me to introduce our next guest, Professor Deepthi Patra. Professor Patra earned his PhD degree from the Electrical Department of NIT Rourkela in the year of 2006. He is currently working as a professor in the Department of Electrical Engineering, NIT Rourkela, India. Her research interest includes digital signal, image, video processing, computer vision, biomedical signal and image processing, statistical process embedded system. He is a senior fellow of IEEE, fellow of IETE India, fellow of the Institute of Engineers India, live member of the India Society of Technical Education. He has co-authored a number of research articles in various journals, conference and book chapter. He has supervised 9 PhD students. She has investigated the research project of ISRO. She has won various prestigious awards in her career. Now I would like to invite HOD Electrical Department, NIT Rourkela, Professor Deepthi Patra, ma'am, to address the audience. Hello, ma'am.
Yeah. So, first of all, my regards to all the distinguished guests, Professor Ramji Prasad, Professor Asutas Datta, and Madam Itisha Mishra. My regards to you all. And my hearty regards to our director, Dr. Biswas. Honorable Director, Professor Animesh Biswas, distinguished chief guest, Professor Ramji Prasad, distinguished guests, Professor Asutas Datta, fellow IEEE and our distinguished alumni of our institute, respected Madam Professor Itisha Mishra, Vice Chairman, IEEE Kolkata Section, my colleague, dear course coordinators, Professor Susmita Das, Dean Faculty Welfare, NIT Rourkela, Professor Suman Kumar De, and Professor Sambit Bakshi. Dear participants from India and abroad, my faculty colleagues, my students, and other guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to invite you all to this 5-day course on 5G, futuristic wireless communication and IoT, that is 5G and beyond, and at large to the Department of Electrical Engineering, because it is my pleasure that our department is organizing number of courses within last 2-3 months. We have organized so many courses, so it is really my pleasure, and I'm really thankful to all the coordinators and all my faculty members for taking so much interest in this, organizing this webinar, where all the participants will be really highly benefited, and our students as well as our faculty members also will be benefited. It is my job now to introduce my department to all of you. Our department, that is a very, I can call the ancient department of of this institute. It was established in 1961, and since its inception, the department is under dynamic progress. Now it is imparting quality education in four MTech specializations and one BTech specialization. We are having four MTech specializations in one in power systems, then power electronics and drives, electronic systems and communication and control system, and BTech in electrical engineering. So besides these postgraduate and undergraduate teaching, a good number of research scholars are also working in diversified areas because we have all diversified areas in our department. The academic and research activities in the department focus on the frontier areas such as power quality studies, distributed generation, soft switching of converters, inverter design, control strategy for complex systems. We have networked control systems, high voltage insulation, energy storage system, signal and image processing, wireless communication, machine learning. All these areas our research scholars are working. The department also hosts two center of excellences. One is on renewable energy system, another on industrial electronics and robotics. And multiple department, faculty from multiple department are participating in these two centers of excellences to boost the interdisciplinary research. The department has well-equipped modern laboratories such as power electronics and drives, signal processing and communication, image processing and computer vision, embedded and real-time system, renewable energy systems, nonlinear dynamics. So all these laboratories with modern facilities we are having. The department also has successfully completed many sponsored research projects from organizations like DRDO, ISRO, DST, CDAC, CSIR, SERB, and MHRD. And it is currently working on 10 sponsored research projects by SERB and TST. Recently, the department has collaborated research program with 8 number of internationally acclaimed universities across the world. And it also conducts various workshops, quality improvement programs, seminars, GYAN courses, and webinars on current technologies for students and people from academia as well as industries. So we know that this 5G is the next generation wireless communication, as already told by our coordinator, and it will have definitely significant socio-economic impact, which will create progressive environment both in academia, industry, and at large in our society. So I hope all the participants from India as well as from abroad, and our faculty members as well as our students, will be highly benefited from this course, as so many distinguished speakers are going to deliver their ideas, whatever they have gained knowledge, they will exchange their ideas, knowledge with us, and we'll be highly benefited. And definitely it will motivate us to do industry collaborative research, and industry academia research collaboration will grow in our department. It will create a lot of, we can call it a lot of scope for many researchers in future. So let me again invite you all to this webinar on behalf of our department. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you, madam, for your talk. So it is also an honor for me to introduce our next guest, Professor Ashutosh Datta. Professor Datta is a fellow IEEE Communication Society Distinguished Lecturer, founding co-chair of IEEE 5G Initiative USA, Johns Hopkins University USA. Professor Datta is currently Senior Wireless Research Scientist, JHU APL, Sabbatical Fellow at Johns Hopkins University Applied Physics Labs, and Adjunct Faculty at Johns Hopkins University, USA. His career spanning more than 30 years includes Director of Technology Security and leads member of technical staff at AT&T, CTO of Wireless at a cybersecurity company, Nixon Incorporated Companies, senior scientist in the in Telecom Aridia Research, Director of Central Research Facility at Columbia University, adjunct faculty at NJIT, and computer engineer with Tata Motors. He has more than 90 conference and journal publication, 3 book chapters, and 31 issued patents. Professor Dotto is a co-author of a book titled Mobility Protocol and Handover Optimization, Design, Evaluation, and Application, published by IEEE and John and Willie, that has recently been translated into Chinese language. He served as the chair for IEEE Princeton Central Jersey Section, Industry Relations Chair for Region 1 and MGA, pre-university coordinator for IEEE MGA, and Vice Chair of Education Society Chapter of PCJS. He co-founded the IEEE STEAM Conference and helped to implement engineering project in community service in several high schools. Professor Dutta currently serves as the Director of Industry Outreach for IEEE Communication Society and is the founding co-chair for IEEE Future Networks Initiative. He also serves as the IEEE Communication Society's Distinguished Lecturer for 2017-2020. He served as the General Co-Chair for the premier IEEE 5G World Forum. He has recipient of the prestigious 2009 IEEE MGA Leadership Awards and 2010 IEEE US Professional Leadership Awards. Professor Dutta is elevated to the status of IEEE Fellow in 2020. He obtained his BS in the Electrical Engineering from NIT Rourkela, India, MS in Computer Science from NJIT, and PhD in the Electrical Engineering from Columbia University, New York. Now I would like invite Professor Ashutosh Dutta to address the session.
Thank you, Professor De. I think it's kind of homecoming for me. The last one you just mentioned, I'm a graduate from NIT Rourkela, 1985 batch. And it's so good to hear what's happened to the institute. And first of all, I'd like to, can you see my, okay. So yes. First of all, I'd like to thank Professor Das, Professor Bakshi, and Honorable Director Professor Biswas, Professor Patra. And at the outset, I also like to thank Professor Ritisha Mishra, I'm a IEEE volunteer. I consider that way. And secondly, I'm so happy that I'm talking to my alma mater. I graduated in 1985. It's been a long history. And then the most importantly, I'm so honored to be sharing the dais with Professor Ramji Prasad, who is a colleague, of course, in IEEE area, but he's also a mentor of my mentor. So I consider him as my guru. Although I didn't take any real teaching from me, I would have been a pleasure to get some teaching from Professor Prasad. But Professor Prasad has really encouraged me to get involved in many of the IEEE activities. And if you remember, Professor Mishra and Professor Das, we had 2017, I think, Professor Prasad, right? We had a 5G summit in Kolkata. And during that time, we really wanted to do something in Rourkela. And I've been trying. So I'm so glad to see that this is happening today. I know this is not the first time. It's going to happen more and more. And I'll be happy to contribute to this effort. So I know I have little time, but and there is a keynote talk coming by Professor Prasad. I also like to thank Professor Sambit Bakshi. 2019, when I visited my alma mater in IIT Rourkela, he took me around and all the departments. I look forward to going again, hopefully soon. And Professor Bishwas, I know I spent some time in the principal or director office. We used to call principal that time, not his director, right? So nice to see you again. And after in 2019. So I'll spend, because I'm now a co-chair for Future Network Initiative, and there are a lot of students here. So I'd like to spend a few minutes just to tell how we can get involved in many of these IEEE activities. Right now, you know, obviously, Professor Day talked about various things, but most importantly, again, today's theme is 5G and IoT. How the 5G communication is going to be all pervasive in every aspect of our life. And Professor Prashad and I, we organized the first 5G summit at Princeton University back in 2015, May 26. And since then, we have been doing about 71 of those. In fact, Professor Prashad also hosted one back in 2017 in Aalborg. So if you see this specific chart, and that kind of drives the motivation for this course, and Professor Das has already talked about what 5G is all about, and we're going to learn more about it, right? So most importantly, it is really a game changer compared to the previous generation, you know, 2G, 3G, 4G, because not only bandwidth, it also massive sensing like and massive IoT, ultra low latency, different kinds of application, right? And if you see here, it's going to really affect every aspect of our life, e-health, robotics at home, intelligent transportation system, car-to-car communication, smart parking, and some of them need high bandwidth, some of them need low latency, some of them need massive connectivity. And in order to be able to provide that or support this application, you need a very flexible, programmable network end-to-end, right? Starting from your high bandwidth on the air, edge cloud, network slicing, SDN and anyway, et cetera. So that's why it is a very interesting time to see how we can contribute to the humanity with all the technical knowledge we have. And that's where IEEE is playing a big role. And within IEEE, I'll focus just on the future networks. This is called Future Direction Committee, which is like an incubation for new idea, emerging technologies, right? And what you can see here, each of these initiatives lasts for about 5 years, then it graduates, then it gets absorbed by other societies. You know, some of the smart cities, software-defined networking have already been graduated. And these are, on the left side, these are the ones which are today we are incubating. And Future Network started in 2016. And then after 1 year, we'll get absorbed by another society, we'll continue to do. So our main role is to really contribute to the evolution of 5G and beyond. I can call it 6 year, 7G. Look at the roadmap, 3 year, 5 year, 10 year, what's happening. Contribute to the education, standardization, conferences, workshops, tutorials, webinar, podcasts, etc. So there is a interesting opportunity for people from around the world, students, researchers, faculty, right? There are about 46 societies about in IEEE, right? 25 or 26 of those, they're actively contributing. There are about 350 volunteers from around the world who are engaged in different way, right? There are about 400 industry advisory board members. We collaborate with government, academia, student community, standards association, education activities. So this is an interesting place for you to contribute. And again, anybody can contribute. You don't have to be a member, but you can join as a volunteer in different ways. If you want to learn more about it, you know, if you go to futurenetworks.IEEE.org, and you can see here, there are many ways you can get involved: conferences, education, publication, standards, roadmap, etc. Right? There are about 10 different working groups, and I'm one of the co-chair. Team Lee is the other co-chair, and we have IEEE staff also supported. And the important part is here, if you see the roadmap, there are about 15 different working groups, millimeter wave, hardware, all spectrum of 5G, security, applications, deployment, AI, ML, et cetera, right? If you can see that there is a past edition of the document got published, and we are now working for the second edition. But in addition to the roadmap, you can also get involved in any other ways. Please visit this if you can. We just concluded the 5G World Forum, supposed to take place in Bangalore. It became virtual. And, you know, the next one is coming. So many ways to get involved. This is the one I was talking about. You know, I put Rourkela here because we got the approval from CompSec headquarters to make it like a one of the 5G summit. And if you can see here, this is the one I was talking about where Professor Prashad and I started back in Princeton with Professor Vinspoor. And you know, I'm hoping we're going to have another 5G summit sometime in 2021, and I'll collaborate with all the faculty, students, and the director of Rourkela, and Dr. Rourkela, and anybody, any volunteers you'd like to speak. So please visit 5gsummit.org. You can get also lots of information there. This is just to give you an idea some of the roadmap working groups. If you want to get involved in the evolution of roadmap, you can visit the website. I'm just showing how you can get there and get connected, right? So depending on your interests and expertise, you can get access to any of these. We also have many test beds around the world. If you want to do some test bed related activities with NSF, or you have suggestion for new working group, you can also come and let us know. These are some contact points. Again, I'm one of the co-chair, but there are roadmap working group co-chairs, there's a program director, program manager. This is like a high-level leadership team, but we have every working group, we have about 15 to 20 members led by working group co-chairs. We meet bi-weekly. We also have lots of workshops, systems optimization, security, each of those. We just had a workshop last week, fast responder tactical community, and many of these are free, actually. So last slide. This is an interesting time. So please join the innovation revolution by getting involved in any of these IEEE activities towards the humanity, advancing the technology for humanity. So with that, thank you again for the kind invitation. I am an alum of NIT Rourkela. So I'm one amongst all of you. I'm an IEEE volunteer. That's my first thing I should be introduced as. I'm happy to be part of any future activities. Thank you again. Have a great day.
Okay, thank you, sir, for your encouraging talk. So it is also an honor for me to introduce our next guest, Professor Iti Shah Mishra. Professor Mishra, Vice Chairman, IEEE Kolkata Section, Communications Society, Chapter, Chair, 2013 to 2018, Jadavpur University, Kolkata. She is the former head of the department and now a professor in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Jadavpur University, Kolkata. She is the recipient of the prestigious Career Award for Young Teachers by All India Counseling of Technical Education, AICTE, in 2004. Obtained IETE Gaudi Memorial Award in 2007 in the Best Paper category. Co-author of several Best Paper Awards in the wireless communication domain. She has authored more than 204 research papers in referred journals such as IEEE, Elsevier, Springer, Wiley, and International Conference, and has filed several patents in cognitive radio network for voice over IP communication and wireless body area network. Professor Mishra is the author of a widely acclaimed textbook, The Wireless Communication and Network, 3G and Beyond, published by McGraw-Hill. She is the co-author of another book, Voice over IP, Communication Challenge and Application, published by Springer International. Her current research interests are in the area of voice over IP, over cognitive radio network, low cost and energy efficient IoT solution, wireless body area networks, radio resource management, 5G networks, and intelligent transport system, etc. She has developed a broadband wireless communication laboratory to carry out advanced research under the wireless communication in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Jadavpur University, Kolkata. Professor Mishra is a senior member of IEEE. She was the chairperson of Communication Society Kolkata chapters, the founder chair of Women in Engineering Affinity Groups, IEEE Kolkata section. Under her leadership, Communication Society Kolkata chapter won chapter achievement awards in 2015 and 2017, and WIE years of the award in 2007. She was a organizing chair for IEEE 5G Summit in 2017 and IEEE Conference CALCON 2020. Now I am requesting Professor Itisha Mishra to address the session. Ma'am, your voice is not audible. Please unmute.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am, okay. It's audible. Yes.
Thank you, Professor Shuman, for introducing me. Respected Chief Guest Professor Ramji Prasad, Professor of Future Technologies for Business Ecosystem Innovation, Aarhus University, Denmark. Professor Ashutosh Datta, John Hopkins University, USA, founding co-chair for IEEE 5G Initiative. Professor Anish Bishash, Director, NIT Rourkela. Professor Sushmita Das, Course Coordinator and Dean, Faculty Welfare. Professor Deepti Patra, HOD, Electrical Engineering Department. Professor Shuman Kumar De and Professor Shambhit Bokshi, the course co-coordinator, respected dignitaries and learned speakers from academics and industry, all participants, a very good afternoon, evening to all of you. I'm very much delighted to be here today as the representative of IEEE volunteers from IEEE Kolkata section and especially from IEEE ComSoc Kolkata chapter. I must thank the organizer for considering IEEE ComSoc as the technical sponsor for this 5-day short-term course on futuristic wireless communication and IoT, 5G and beyond that will be held during the time 7 to 11 November 2020. The topic itself is self-explanatory. It is the prime focus of IEEE and industry development in the era of wireless communication all over the world. 5G, IoT are the much discussed topic today for academia in pursuing research and industries for business. Very recently, an international network generations and roadmap, INGR, is established, which is an IEEE 5G and beyond technologies roadmap. Hope Professor Datta talk about these issues. The first executive summary related to all development are available in future networks, IEEE.org roadmap. I must thank the coordinators for arranging this excellent short-term course with bringing so many IEEE fellows, distinguished speakers, and industry people from Qualcomm, Huawei, Radio Standards, Bell Labs, Samsung Semiconductors, and many more. I'm very much sure participants will learn many new developments happening for 5G and beyond for future networks. I sincerely acknowledge the opportunity created in this short-term course by arranging two ComSoc virtual distinguished lecturer program will be delivered by Professor Ashutosh Datta from John Hopkins University, USA, and IEEE fellow on the topic security in SDN, NFV, and 5G networks, opportunities and challenges on 7th November at 6:30 p.m. SDN and NFV technologies are complementary. SDN focuses on the control plane, while NFV focuses on optimizing the actual network services, managing data flows, in which the security is a big issue. The second VDL will be delivered by Professor Sudeep Mishra from IIT Kharagpur, humble fellow, Germany, on the topic UAV networks, architecture, opportunities, challenges, and future on 8th November at 8:30 a.m. Unmanned aerial vehicle, in short UAV, an aircraft that is guided automatically, has special application in the military services in the aircraft. We are more familiar with the term drone for autonomous control nowadays. Professor Mishra has his credit of a long list of many awards and recognition. We are very fortunate to get him as distinguished lecturer. My sincere gratitude to both of the speakers under ComSoc Kolkata chapter VDL. ComSoc Kolkata chapter is a very vibrant chapter working under IEEE Kolkata section over 17 years in the cause of development of communication society, organizing year-long technical lectures program, workshops, international conferences, DSP and DLT, student paper and design model contests, etc. This chapter is also associated with many 5G summit. In 2017, I was the organizing chair for Kolkata 5G summit, organized first time in Kolkata in association with Professor Ramji Prasad sir and Professor Ashutosh Datta. It was an excellent experience for me with enormous opportunity to learn by organizing this 5G summit. I believe in this workshop, many students have joined who are the future contributors of the technology development in the field of IEEE cause and development issues for 5G, IoT and beyond. I request students to be engaged in the IEEE activities for continuous professional development and networking through by forming ComSoc student branch to initiate your activities. And I request the present coordinator to help the student in your department and also the HOD, Professor Patra. I am hopeful every participant will enjoy the learning scope in a wide variety of the field of 5G IoT and beyond through this workshop to shape up their future research interest. I wish the very success of this workshop. My heartfelt thank to all of you for your patience hearing and inviting me for these big issues. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, madam, for your talk. So now I take the privilege to introduce our next guest, our Honorable Director, Professor Animesh Vishwas. Professor Animesh Vishwas is an electronics and telecommunication engineer with BE degree from Calcutta University, PhD from IIT Delhi, and postdoc from Oregon State University, USA. Since 1993, he has been teaching at IIT Kanpur. He took over as director of NIT Rourkela in 2016. Professor Vishwas' research interests cover electromagnetic and microwave technique. His academic interest includes introduction of electronics, electromagnetic theory, UHB and microwave technology, antennas and propagation, microwave circuits, microwave measurement and design, computational electromagnetic and advanced engineering electromagnetics for PG. He has also published more than 200 international journals and conference papers. He is a fellow of IETE and Institute of Engineers, India. As an academic administrator, he stands for simplification and administrative procedures, greater choice for the student in selection of courses, enhance freedom to the faculty to combine research and teaching, creative project works, and greater interaction with industry. Now I would like to invite our Honorable Director, Professor Animesh Vishwas sir, to address the audience.
Thank you, Suman. Good evening to everyone. It's my pleasure to welcome you all to the inaugural ceremony of this 5 days continuing education program on futuristic wireless communication and IoT 5G and beyond.
Sir, please switch on your video. Sir, please.
Okay. I congratulate HOD Electrical Engineering Professor Dipti Patra, course coordinator Professor Susmita Das, course co-coordinators Professor Suman Kumar Day from Electrical Engineering and Professor Sambit Bakshi from Computer Science Department for organizing this virtual program. On behalf of NIT Rourkela, I heartily welcome today's distinguished guests who are highly recognized in the field of wireless communication technology globally. Professor Ramji Prasad, Professor Ashutosh Datta, and Professor Iti Shaha Mishra in this inaugural session. I'm happy to see a good number of participants from academia and industries have enrolled in this program. This virtual program is aimed at deliberating the emerging wireless communications technologies and IoT for 5G and beyond applications. As all of us are quite aware that 5G will be a connectivity fabric of new era of information technology, which will transform every sector of economy and society. Not only it has the potential to improve the quality of life through high data rate communication, but also it offers low latency and massive connectivity for new applications for mobile, e-health, autonomous vehicles, smart cities, smart homes, industrial IoTs, etc. So it is necessary to study the impact of 5G and future 6G communications technologies and applications. As I see that various lectures are going to be delivered by the expert from academia and industry over the coming 5 days, I hope that all participants will be truly benefited attending these programs. Thank you all. Wish you all the best.